Alright, so looking at our situation, I'm starting to max out on comms, and when I review my upgrades here, it just lists the one I already have for the comm station, the additional comm spot, so I don't think I can get another comm location, so if I want to expand my contacts, I need to build a new comm station altogether, which means we need to get places like these torn apart faster. Which more or less means I should probably get more engineers in general, so we can both clear debris faster, but also have certain areas manned, like for the Psy Laboratory and stuff like that. But at the moment, I don't have a ton of events to go on, because, let's see, I need to upgrade the Shadow Chamber and Skulljack a Codex. I forgot about the Shadow Chamber part. So let's look at the upgrade real quick again. 200 supplies, 4 power, so I can't do it till next turn anyway. I do have the power for it. So, yeah. Basically, at this point, all that's left to do is pass time, I believe. And go make contact with somewhere. I figure we know there's a base up here, so I may as well start moving towards North America. Although I'm a little bit worried about that UFO right there. What if we fly to New Australia? Can I just manually fly somewhere? Oops. I actually genuinely don't know if I'm allowed to fly my ship around. Let's see. Resistance network, what does that do? What am I toggling? Just whether or not certain whether or not that location shows up, I guess. I guess I'll just leave it on, because then I won't be confused about how many places are in North America. I think there was two earlier. I think I thought there was two earlier because that one wasn't showing up. It's good to keep in mind. So there are 3 locations in the 2 places, so I need a total of 16 contacts, so I definitely need a comm station to add the next 5. What if I just go back to the Resistance HQ?
Setting course for Sector 1, the Arctic.
Where's that UFO going? Yeah, he's going the other way. I'm not really planning on doing much at the HQ, but I want to try to make sure the UFO goes away before I try to make contact with the North America. But for now, yeah, maybe it'll be now.
You have made considerable progress against the aliens over the past month, Commander. I hope that your ongoing efforts will only lead to further success.
Cool, that should mean we have a supply drop. That'll give me something to do. So our 3 things we have to deal with, potentially, a UFO, a breakthrough of 1 victory point, and a rapid response. Guaranteed reinforcements on all guerrilla ops for a month. Oh, geez. That's not very good. yeah, let's go investigate the supplies. That gives me something to do for a few days. Well, I basically am waiting for the next event to trigger. Also waiting for that kind of money, though. Now that money's in, I can go buy things. Such as that shadow upgrade. We can go back to HQ if we want to. I'm gonna stay put for a second here. I'll probably go buy an engineer, because I feel like we're constantly short on those. There's just elements of the base that would be improved by having more engineers. Also my weapons, though. Let's review again how my weapons are doing. I need 305 supplies total to finish my weapon upgrades. I should probably just do those right now, but let's get some basic stuff out of the way. Like the Shadow Chamber upgrade. There's our Psionic Gate. Psionic Gate. Takes 10 Illyrium crystals, 65 supplies. The map coordinate data recovered from the Codex brain led us to this. A powerful psionic artifact embedded deep in the wilderness. The question is, if there is truly a gateway, what lies on the other side? What could go wrong, right? 5 days of creepy research. Probably enough time to get that done before anything else triggers, too. How's my event queue doing? Supply drop in 20 days. I should check for that more often. That does help clear up how much time I have to wait. Wow, we'll still be trying to clear machinery until then, too. I think I do want to go buy an engineer so I can fill up more slots, because obviously we're restricted here. And I think... What happens if I put a second guy here? I can only put a soldier here? I can't put a second character there? Why is... Interesting. Rose and Gandhi are both here. That's fine. Only two people are wounded now. That's also good news. Let's go ahead and buy those upgrades real quick. I want them. I want them, damn it. I've been waiting. Oh. I'm out of Valerium crystals. Oh well. A sword and a pistol are kind of low priority. I'd prioritize the pistol in particular. I'm starting to think I might be done with the sword altogether. The ability to shoot twice in a row with a shotgun is pretty amazing. So that might have been the deciding factor in me maybe not using swords anymore. Which I think have quickly reduced in usability over time. I could place more radio towers to increase our income, since I can't buy any upgrades. Let's go ahead and get back to the HQ.
Setting course for the Arctic territories.
We can get more good recruits. An engineer, probably not a scientist, because we're running out of science to do at this point. But more engineers means more digging, for example, which is totally worthwhile.
Welcome, Commander.
245 supplies. And then what's the... Oh, there is no soldier to hire this time, so I don't even get the option. Yeah, let's get the engineer. Welcome to the crew. So I get a bonus for rapid construction. My curiosity is whether rapid construction affects clearing alien debris also. Because that would be good too. Anyway, I think I'm just going to assign this character to also help out over here. Hey, newbie. Get busy digging. That'll take 20 days. Oh, it takes less time. Interesting. There we go. So in about 20 days, we'll be good to go. I am curious about whether or not clearing debris counts towards this bonus. Let's
Welcome,
see.
Commander.
25 supplies for rapid construction. They assist with facility and excavation projects. While the adventurer is scanning at this location, decreased... I just skimmed this and it went horribly. Resistance volunteers assist with facility and excavation projects while the Avenger is scanning at this location, decreasing the required construction time. So it'll get rid of the current bonus, which is rapid healing, but my new war center kind of nullifies that a bit. At this point, passing the time is kind of the thing to do. I'm not in the biggest hurry to make contact over there. I don't want the UFO to catch me, wherever they are. But for the most part, we need to wait a little bit for the next events to happen. And I need to excavate so I can expand my contacts. Oh yeah, clearing machinery is only going to take 11 days. Here we go. This is what I was waiting for. A mission! Oh, one mission. No options this time. That's unusual. We'll get a ooh! Oh, it's Scipio! It's a chance to get my own character back. I was wondering when that was going to come up. So if I do this mission, my reward is to get my sharpshooter back along with 100 intel, I think it said. 101 intel. Extract the VIP from... Oh, it's an extraction mission. That's how I lost that character in the first place. I'll have my EMP stuff ready, so I should be more prepared this time. We're going to deal with Codex, Elite Lancer, Elite Shield Bearer, Sectopod, Elite Trooper, Elite Officer, Heavy Mech Archon. Whew. No mention of a gatekeeper, that's good news. Archons aren't great news. Heavy mech is not great news. In particular, the sectopods is something to worry about, but I like how many of those things are just soldiers, because that often makes the mission easier. Alright, good luck, everybody.
Setting course for Sector 5,
I wonder if I'm supposed
India.
To extract a regular VIP, or if I'm supposed to extract Scipio himself. That'll be interesting. If the person I'm extracting is actually a unit for my army. Yeah, they're gonna keep pushing me for the Skulljack. I am not, repeat, I am not using a Skulljack during an extraction mission. I've lost too many characters during these kinds of missions before. I'm not gonna try to trigger any sort of special events now. There's a codex in like every mission. I'll use it during a boring one where it's like, go hack that terminal. Alright, you hack the terminal. Oh shit, codexes are here still. I guess we'll skulljack them and see what happens. That's the right time. Alright, the gang's all here. We got a huge variety of tools and tricks along the way. I have the skulljack because it can be used to straight up murder a dude sometimes, which is handy. Got the battle scanner, venom rounds, hazmat suit on Gandhi like usual. Everyone's got their switched over to their my favorite weapon of each type, like the most upgraded one. Our ranger has both flashbang and mimic to help keep alive. Our grenadier actually doesn't have any plasma grenades this time. He specifically has utility grenades. He has a acid grenade for eating through armor, and he has an EMP grenade for taking out the big robotic enemies. So, which is the biggest thing that's going to help me with the sectopod when it shows up. Everything else is pretty straightforward. We have one of everything, two snipers, because, well, you guys are used to my playstyle by now. Let's go.
Sky Ranger deploy.
Squad green to deploy.
Resistance is asking for our help in extracting a VIP who had been providing reconnaissance data in this area. We've got the coordinates, but it's likely we'll have to clear out a contingent of hostile forces to make this work. Menace 1-5, target coordinates incoming. Secure the VIP and proceed to the evac volume for extraction. Advent already knows we're here, so your position isn't concealed for the extraction.
It's always these settings. Alright, yep. I wonder if they're required. They probably are required to be in a city setting. I think that's probably the case. It's probably where the VIPs tend to be. But yeah, the hardest thing to me about VIP missions, aside from the time limit where people get left behind, is just the fact that they're always these very vertical locations. Which, like, getting off this gas station we're starting off on, that's easy. But, getting to our destination can be rough, so I'm gonna take a look around. It's a little hard to see right now. Oh, look, a ladder. Is that in the direction? Ooh! That is a favorable ladder location right there. Just try not to blow it up or anything. The last time I did a VIP mission is when we lost two characters, including the guy we're trying to save right now, and it was specifically scary because it was on top of the it was on the second floor roof of a building where the two floors were different sizes, so you had to walk onto one roof. You either had to circle around behind the entire building and climb a ladder all the way to the top, or if you climbed on the front side of it, you had to run along the roof, along the first story roof to then get to the second story roof because the ladders were so weirdly laid out and the floors were so weirdly shaped. But this time I think I got a little luckier with the ladder placement, so let's see if we can get in and out in 12 turns, where obviously the biggest concern is, where the hell is the VIP?
That's affirmative.
Sticking behind cover. Hopefully we'll spot something. Nothing, huh? Decent chunk of progress towards our destination down there. It's a little surprising not to see anything there. Let's get people's first action down first, especially for the non-snipers. Whoa. Wait, Scipio's in my party right now. Oh. I already have the VIP. That's unexpected. I did not know that was how this was going to play out. I thought I had to go find the VIP and save them. I have my sniper. He's right here in my party with no weapon, and I have to try to keep him alive. Which means that I have to be extra careful about keeping him protected, because he probably can get straight up killed. So we have to be careful here, because the moment I get detected by the enemy, we're going to start fighting. I might want to throw out a battle scanner, just to start figuring out what this level looks like. That is quite the arm. So immediately that is two Advent soldiers and a Codex hanging out together, out in the open. Right in front of the building we're trying to get to, so we're going to want to clear the way. I'm sure no one can shoot them from here. Makes me question how I want to move forward exactly. If I go too far forward, we trigger attacks. Because the moment we see them, they should see us, right? And the game doesn't have any system for being able to tell what they will see. Because normally, if you see them, they see you, and it's mutual, and everyone's screwed.
I'm trusting you here.
trying to figure out how to approach here. Alright. Grappling hook man. No spots forward, only backwards. Lockdown's here. Let's just keep him in the back and safe. Get him to cover. No what? Too bad we didn't bring him a weapon, huh? Then he'd be really useful. You think he'd have the forethought to be like, hey, we're rescuing one of our soldiers. Maybe we could grab one of our his weapons to use so that he doesn't die during his attempted rescue. That'd be pretty sweet.
I'm on it.
I wonder if I can get in a range to void rift that guy, that party. So that'd be a pretty fantastic way to open things. Nope, not quite. Agonizingly one tile off. That would have been a satisfying way to start the fight. I could do an EMP bomb. Nope, it wouldn't reach the codex. And also, obviously, I want to keep that bomb around for the inevitable mech fight that comes up later. Let's see if we're going to trigger something. Still in the clear. Starting to wonder what it takes to trigger this fight. That's a Urity in your secondary action. So unless we can't do much with you either. This is a little awkward. I'm wondering if I should put people in Overwatch and then run and let the one person move forward and then see if they would all trigger the Overwatch or not. But I think the line of sight's totally fucked because of this awning up here. As far as I can tell. It's funny, placing that battle scanner has only paralyzed me further as far as trying to figure out how to proceed next. I could also throw another one down here to find out what's going on elsewhere. Let's save it for now. This could be a good sniping spot for you. We'll just keep moving forward. I think Zulu's gonna risk moving forward. I'm going to avoid putting people into Overwatch. We'll see if we trigger anything. But more than anything, we just want our characters to move forward, because them being stuck back there is just too little motion for the first turn. There's no cover down there. Could send the heavy down. Can't go across the street yet, because we won't get to cover. Then go hide behind the planter. It does feel like that's just giving up a height advantage, though.
Is this all sicher?
C'est comme vous voudrez.
That'll hopefully suffice as a decent sniping position. We just need to get across this block.
Okay, I'll go.
Spreading our characters out slightly in case of some kind of area of effect damage happening that might threaten a few of them. I guess they're still too close together for the codex. Oh, what did I just click on? What? How did I... Shit. How did I even click there? What? I was clicking on the roof, and I somehow clicked through the building. That's scary. Maybe they won't notice me? They did not notice me, as it turns out. Can my sniper can't see them either, so this awning absolutely screws with the line of sight then. Alright, it's good to know. And they're somehow gone from my line of sight now. Worrying. Hey, grappling hook guy. No opportunity. Can't grappling hook to that roof anymore. I mean, Gandhi's already down here. May as well try to take cover.
Moving to position.
There they are. Yeah, no one can. Apparently, no one can see them.
Commander, that codex provides the ideal opportunity to infiltrate the Advent network.
Well, now they can probably see them.
Move in with the Skulljack to initiate the process.
I can try to mind control with a decent chance of success, but they're just regular. They're just crappy little Advents, so it might not be that interesting. Whereas the teleporting codex would be more interesting, but definitely something like the big tougher guys would be really cool to take out. Let's see. Stasis could disable somebody, but they won't be able to be attacked. Let's see. If I flashbang the codex, they won't be able to do much. I have to be careful how to aim this, though, or I'll hit Gandhi. Aim right down here. There we go. This should stop the codex from splitting when I attack it. Oh, wow, that was a pro throw, wasn't it? It bounced off the roof. That is some bubble aim cheating shit right there. We can target the fuel pump, which is amusing, when we'll probably kill Gandhi. Or I can shoot this codex in its dumb little face. Deadeye is more of a guaranteed kill, but it's less than half of a chance of working, unfortunately. Only 8 to 10. I'll go for it. Wow. It's a flashy dodge.
Loopy.
Alright, we'll have to keep moving then. If I get in the right position, I could probably shoot that guy twice. I just don't want to blow up the gas tank, really. I'm not trying to. I feel like there's a likelihood of it, though.
Was ist da drüben?
So if I fire at the... So 71% chance of hitting Codex, won't kill, but what if I go for two shots? Chain shot on the Codex. What am I aiming at right now? Yeah, there we go. 50. Not the best hit chance, but it'll try to shoot twice for a lot of damage. Alternatively, hail of bullets is a nice guaranteed hit that would use up my ammo, but this guy gets free reloads. So guarantee would not be bad. I think his current gun gets two free reloads. So he'll get some mileage out of that. Let's see here. We can get cover behind this vehicle. Can't really see, it's half cover. That should give me an opportunity to attack the Codex.
This will be okay.
I don't think anyone's currently in Overwatch. Oh, right, they can't be in Overwatch because they haven't had a turn yet. What can I hack? Not now, this is not the time. Fire weapon on Codex, 99% chance, absolutely. There we go.
That's it.
So what do I want to do with Nightmare here? I can do guaranteed damage, 5 to 7. Ooh, guaranteed damage past the shields would be nice, 1, 2, 3, 4... Yeah, if I do exactly 7, I win. If I don't, which is more likely than we don't, but he'll be very close to going down. Let's take these guys out.
Your mind is your weakness.
He likes charging his psychic ball. We need to do 5 damage to get past the shield now, because he took the minimum damage. And the only remaining unit is my sniper that can't see anything from here. That's a good sign. Is this the boundary of the map? Oh, it totally is. Cool. So I can rely on that direction of cover if I want to. Could take him with a pistol shot. This high point doesn't do me any good with that stupid gas station balcony getting in my way anyway. But I can lightning hands this dude. For no damage. Crap. What can I grapple to, by the way? Oh, now I can get on this roof. Interesting. But it's mostly dangerous. I mean, we might as well take the lightning hand shot. Sweet. It was almost pointless. Oh, that's frustrating. So no one else has an action right now. I guess we'll overwatch.
Affirmative, covering now.
And you should probably stay put. And just hide. We took out the Codex before it could run around like a lunatic and cause problems, but we didn't actually do that much about their team overall. A lot of time was spent really awkwardly moving around while we try to get past the fact that there's a gas station balcony in the way. And he missed. A melee attack. It was a surprise. Oh, Unfortunately, I didn't end up. Oh, what's he doing? Oh, just the shield. That's fine. Well, it's not great. It's a lot of damage. It's still a lot of shield, but it could be worse. Free reload. I think I'm gonna go try to chain shot their leader. Neither of them are over. Yeah, no one's in Overwatch right now. I'm probably gonna try to do a chain shot on their shield bearer, which will wipe out their shield. It actually might be enough to not even bother with chain shot. 61% chance of hitting. 8 to 10 damage means that it will do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If I do 8 damage, then it will not get through his shield and his everything else. I probably should just go for the chain shot, even though it's not a great hit chance. 46. It reduces my chance to hit just enough to be a bit of a gamble, but it's probably overall a better chance of success. Yeah. There we go. That was damaging. Oh wait, I mixed up. I was mixing up chain shot with the double shot that the shotgunner can use. The shotgunner just does two shots. Period. The chain shot, the first one has to hit. So I actually made my chances of success worse by taking that gamble. And in true XCOM fashion, I did the mathematically bad idea, and it worked out. So let's not question this too much, huh? Let's see. I do want to move forward before. I don't want to just stay here. So let's move forward. And I'll come shoot him straight in the face. Because we don't want to waste too many turns staying put and hunkered down as our time limit ticks away. Hey, buddy. 100% chance of boom! How's that feeling?
Enemy destroyed!
There's another one for Rose's kill count. Implacable. Alright, the turn's not over yet. So that little quirk. Don't know where I'd want to go yet. Let's see. Long shot's way up here. I think I'm gonna have this. Yeah, we're gonna have her try to grab the treasure real quick. It's not a safe spot, but she'll be going after the. She's gonna go to the telephone pole as her next action. Do we see anyone new? Hey, advanced expanded magazine twice. I wonder if that's a double-sized magazine at that point. So there's our building. It's still annoyingly far away. So let's not lose too much time here. Pressing forward a little more. We're just gonna go for cover. Right now, it's that building is a terrible place for snipers. Unfortunately. Running out of actions, so I want to be careful not to run too far forward, because we could trigger a new encounter by doing so. Hopefully this doesn't count as going too far forward. Not yet. Alright, cool, that's good news. Down to just these three characters.
Rolling.
I'm gonna try to press in this general direction and stick to the best cover we can find along the way. The gas station was a scary spot to hang out, obviously, because it can explode. But the enemies didn't take advantage of that, and we survived. So let's just keep going forward and keep an eye out for their mech. Little low on fantastic cover points. I'll go up here.
Solid copy.
Oh, that's actually further forward than anyone else. That could be the tragic action. Nope, not this time. They could still wander over towards me though on their turn. All right, so far everyone's alive. I have 7 units to walk around with. We need to cross the street and right. Yeah, that ladder right there is my goal. We just need to go from here to there, which is like 2 or 3 turns of moving, which in itself is not the worst thing ever. But who knows where the bad guys are. So I'm going to go to Ed. Oh, wow. Ed's up front, huh? Lost track of him. There we go. We're going to want to use a battle scanner. Find out where the bad guys are if we can. Hi. Well, I found the sectopod. Just regular troopers with him. That's not bad. He's not very durable, is he? Oh, that's not his health bar. That's a normal trooper's health bar. I'm like, what? Oh, wait, no, is that his health bar? That can't be his health bar. That has to be the that must be a shield bearer, right? The Sectopod's health bar must not be showing up, because there's no way he only has 7 hit points. That'd be weird. Our goal's right there. Technically, we want to go this way, and not towards the Sectopod. But I don't really trust him to not join the fray. I don't know. We'll send Rose forward and see what we get away with.
Good copy. Moving on target.
See what does and doesn't get triggered along the way. Technically, we can get to that ladder without fighting it, maybe. I will gladly do this mission with as few fights as possible, since it's we're trying to do an extraction. The last thing I want to do is get somebody else trapped. We'll use Atheist next. Is that risky? We kind of have to go in that direction regardless.
Okay, I'll go.
Careful. It is spooky not knowing the exact limits of line of sight in this game. Oh, I should have used Running Gun. Can I still use it? I guess I can.
Getting in close.
Now I can still make it. Now that enables me to still do something at the end of my turn if something triggers. Nothing triggered. I'm choosing to ignore these towers. I think they only do something if I'm in stealth mode, because then they notice you, obviously. I don't think they matter right now. Oh, oh no! Oh no! There's a second floor here. It's the old nightmare. It's back. There's a second floor here, and there's no the ladder only goes from that roof to that roof. It doesn't tell me how to get. How do I scale this building? There's a pipe on the back, just like last time, to taunt me. So I could take that pipe, but we're absolutely gonna have to fight the Sectopod along the way. Alright, so that's gonna be my new goal then. Our new goal is to go up that pipe right there. Cause I don't know how else we'll get around. We could go inside we could break through a window and go up that staircase, I guess. And that'll allow us to go up through here. Yeah, that might not see the bad guys. I feel like reaching the top of the staircase, there must be a window here, right? I think that through that window they're gonna see us. The safest thing is to get the drop on them, I think. So let's get in a position to attack them. A lot of that hinges on Claymore's EMP bomb, which he cannot reach them with right now. So we want to make a good approach.
Is this all sicher?
Let's see here. Not in range yet. That'll be more of a next turn thing, I think. I think we're mostly going to be doing Overwatch right now. Let's review our hacking opportunities real quick. I'm going to hack one of these guys.
Attempting infiltration.
This is purely just because I think that's supposed to help you basically grind your hacking skills so you do better in the future. So I'm... Since I'm planning on probably overwatching and then attacking next turn, I think I'm just going to see what I can do here. Let's see. Soldier aim increased by 15 and crit chance by 25 for... What? What? So you can increase the character's aim and crit, which is good, sure, fine. The one that makes it last 3 turns... is easier than the one that makes it last for 2 turns, which is easier, which I'm more likely to fail. Oh, squad! The entire squad. Oh my god, that's fantastic. I'm totally aiming for that. Don't screw me! Oh, yes. For a second there, I thought the game was horribly wrong about something, and then I know soldier versus squad. I'm like, oh, okay. Thank god. I thought the game lost its mind. That'll help us take them down next turn.
I'm in!
Alright. I totally just hacked for the sake of it, though, because I was just trying to make them better at hacking, basically. Alright. Overwatch. Do I just go straight to Overwatch, or do I move forward? Let's Overwatch with our sniper. Zulu's still here. We can throw down a Mimic Beacon. I'm going to stay put for now. Next turn, we can make a mess of things. This turn, let's just try to stay safe. Can I move Scipio to a better spot? Oh yeah. That's closer to our goal, at least. While still behind same amount of cover. Gandhi? I could inch forward, but that risks blowing our cover and it's only for worse cover. Please walk closer. Oh, they are. Kind of. Oh. Well, that breaks our stealth. Oh. I think that was a kill. Yeah, okay. At least it was a kill. Don't know what they're gonna do now. That guy has a lot of armor. Ooh, I don't know. Did he get to do a proper action? By the way, my character just shot straight at Gandhi. That was worrying. I'm surprised he was able to penetrate armor with a pistol shot. Oh wow, we're actually doing noticeable damage to this guy. If only he triggered first right with the armor shredding, he'd be... Wow. That was the... So I thought I was kind of biding time with that action. I was totally sitting here thinking like, alright, we're gonna just lie in wait and then get ready for our ambush next turn. And I accidentally stumbled into what was basically my most effective Overwatch ever, as far as getting everyone to participate, basically. Alright. His armor is shredded. His armor shredded. He's EMP'd. This should kill him, basically. That little hacking effort, I think, led us into a situation where our chance of hitting was so good that we just demolished that guy. Which was satisfying. There should be one soldier hanging out. Yeah, he's a shield bearer, but with no one to defend at this point. The biggest concern is what other troops might be lying in wait in the distance. If I go up here, I can target him.
Orders confirmed.
We'll find out what happens. New bad guys? Yes, no?
I've got eyes on admin troops.
Ooh. Is that just three soldiers? Oh, that's a mech. Hi. I was gonna pump that guy full of attacks, but let's throw up a distraction real quick. Maybe not. Let's see here. Gandhi. Before I do anything else, what can you do here? The range is not good. Yeah, we spread ourselves out a bit here. That's not good either. Definitely gonna want to put aid protocol in Rose before we do anything else. There we go. That'll increase our defense. We have a sniper who can target basically everyone, huh? Taking out the mech would definitely come in handy. Serial gives you refunds for kills, but the kills don't seem super likely. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7... Yeah, that guy has 10 hit points, so... Only if I get a perfect shot will I kill that guy. Grappling hook opportunities are generally in a non-favorable direction. Or over here in plain sight where he'd be likely to get shot. Let's try to move forward with Gandhi. We'll see what happens. I wanted to see if we can get into psychic range to do anything. But I think I have overextended myself in this rushing mission. Agonizing. His best action... he sucks at throwing, as you'd expect. His best action is probably just to overwatch from here. Or just sprint forward, actually. I can keep moving forward and just hope for the best. Although wounding my psychic would suck. Maybe I will just take a shot. 94 is pretty damn good. That is the optimum situation, though. He'll take half his health of damage only if we don't lose all that much health. I think this giant Overwatch is the best thing to do at this point.
This area is mine.
Gives me an opportunity to hurt a lot of different units. See, as far as I can tell, I have to get pretty close to be able to attack. Yeah. So if I overwatch from here, Atheist is not likely to get much done. If I rapid fire, it's 8 to 10 damage, and it's twice in a row. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's 10 damage right there. I don't know why it's listed so low then. So I can do a lot of damage with a rapid fire. This is the last officer. I think I'm going to take it on the mech. Yeah. 86 is pretty damn good, honestly. I was thinking about doing a mimic beacon. But this could be really strong, actually. Or not. Well, that was underwhelming. High hit chance is no guarantee, obviously. Obviously, as we learn again and again. Lockdown can't do anything. Nightmare can't do anything. The best action might just be to get closer. Give them more diverse targets. Maybe even ones they have to re-maneuver to attack. Right down here. Their hit chance should be kind of garbage at that range. So let's give them a few different targets.
On your order.
I would have preferred not to have done what I did with Rose. We'll keep moving our defensive character forward. Full cover over here. Alright. This was a busy turn. It's still the same turn as the one where I fought the Sectopod. Yeah, they're not happy. But are they gonna run? Are they gonna... Yep! Threat assessment, bitch! I love that free Overwatch from Threat Assessment. It's so great. Oh, there's an enemy down there. I think there's a codex down there. Yeah, there is. Come on. There's that bonus accuracy.
I think I got a piece.
I was gonna say, how is that not triggering Overwatch? There's some damage. He's not down though, unfortunately.
Deflection.
It was definitely worth it to do the Overwatch. Who's he gonna shoot at? Oh. That's not good. He shot an explosive vehicle, so now we need to get out of there before it explodes. He actually managed to miss my main character somehow. That was an unusually effective Lancer. What the did it explode?
VIP is down. Move to rendezvous with Firebrand for extraction.
Fuck me. I didn't get an action. Wow. Well, fuck. Scipio's dead. Wow, that was not the expected outcome for me at all. Look at the bait. Look at the obvious target. Wow, I was wondering how I was going to keep Rose safe. And no one shot her at all. She's surrounded by enemy units and nobody shot her. Also, this thing's showing up and I don't think the game wants me to know they exist yet. Well, shit. So this entire mission's a failure just like that, because the... Wow. I did not expect them to take that kind of shot from across the entire map like that. That's rough. There's the Lancer. Being a dick. We can revive our Lancer with our support. I mean, sorry, revive our... I was going to call them psychics at this point. Our Psy unit. And he's not happy about that, about what happened a second ago, so he's going to be taking some sweet revenge, probably. Maybe that Lancer will become mine, for example. Oh, did I just double click on accident? Shit. Well, I don't know what the percent of chance of... I didn't even get to see the percent success chance because I accidentally double clicked. Shit. That is such a bad move to make on my part. 74% chance of obliteration. Really could shoot most of them, but the, let's take out the Lancer so we don't have to worry about him anymore. Come on. Oh, he's still hanging in there. He's poisoned. Is that enough to kill him? It is. Cool. We'll ignore him then. He's gonna die of poison. Who's wounded right now? We're a few different characters need to heal at this point. Is anyone doing an Overwatch? You're doing Overwatch, huh? Who's a nasty little bastard? Oh, Rose is out of ammo. Do you get a free reload? If I don't move, I should still get to shoot, right?
It's killing time.
A lot of people can shoot the mech, but I don't want this guy to Overwatch anyone. See what I can here. Damn. Yes, Overwatch removed, along with their brain and other key components. That was unexpectedly expective. I mean, effective. Unexpectedly expective. Language, please.
Moving to position.
That's really tragic that the mission just failed just like that. Because the car exploded. I thought cars usually smoke for a little longer than that. I guess I'm wrong. I might as well do lightning hands, because why not? It's free. Free damage.
Armor still holding.
I can keep firing away at him if I want to, but really the point is to get away from the fire and stuff. We need to heal this character. We need to heal both of them, but mostly top notch.
Go help him out.
Alright, two of their troops are down. One's fully dead, one's almost dead. Oh yeah, Rose still can move because of Implacable. I have an acid bomb that I could fire for guaranteed kill. Otherwise, we have to shoot. A lot of fire around here. That's the best path I can take.
Was ist da drüben?
Don't burn yourself.
Das ist da drüben.
69 is garbage hit chance, but I only have one shot. So the acid bomb would be a guaranteed kill. Which I might want to do at this point. Is there nobody else to shoot left? Zulu just has a move. Top Notch has a pistol shot that sucks. Claymore. That's all we have. I'm going to go for the guaranteed kill. Even though it's kind of a waste of the resource. Because having this guy stick around is bad for us. It could be devastating to let him get another action. That was less killy than I expected. His armor's gone, though, so I should be able to pistol shot him to death now, right? 94% chance of murder. There we go. If I did that in a slightly different order, then my lightning reflexes would have killed him. And my lightning hands would have killed him, and then nothing else would have been necessary. I think you're going to stay put. If I move forward, we can trigger something new that we don't want to have happen. I'm really annoyed that character's dead right now. God damn it. I already failed him once and I got a second chance, and now he's dead again. Sweet.
Okay, bin unterwegs.
Not a good start for the revive, unfortunately. You are so far back. Okay. I could reload. Mostly I think I just want to sprint though. She's just so far back, and I don't want to leave somebody behind again on one of these missions. That we know there's a codex down there because the game accidentally revealed it to me without actually starting the fight somehow. Oh, is that a pipe there too? Can I climb that? I think I missed that at first. I think that's a climbing point. I can always check with Rose. It is. Fantastic. So there's our extract point. And everyone's pretty good at getting up there because the character that was vulnerable is dead now. Whoops. Let's go ahead and sneak over here.
Okay.
I think he can just grappling hook onto the roof. I'm just really hoping... The problem here is that any of my actions could trigger a new fight that I'm not really ready for. So everything's a little spooky. You should definitely heal Gandhi now. He's next in line. Well, I guess it's a good thing that I recruited a new sniper, which is on this mission, because I'm... Not getting my old one back. Not that one in particular. Rhodes can make it on the roof, but I think that forward momentum will, that forward movement will mostly trigger new encounters I'm not looking for right now.
Move.
Let's just get our characters over there. And once we're kind of clumped up a little bit, we can all start running up the ladder. We still have 6 turns, so there's no reason to be too hasty right now.
Hoffentlich lohnt sich das.
Oh. That was... Oh, fuck me. Apparently that was all we needed. Ah, ha, 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 ha. 48% chance. 2 shots could do damage. I'm just going to prioritize a Mimic Beacon real quick. That'll buy us some time. Look at that. Some kind of soldier standing in the open. How could that be? Who would do such a thing? What are they, some kind of idiot? I don't know. Might as well overwatch. Not going to go anywhere else from here. Can't do any... Still have a time limit on aid protocol. Can't move any further, so at this point, overwatch makes the most sense. Oh, he's not interested in the beacon. Probably because I threw it directly in front of his face in a really obvious fashion, but still. There's some damage. Aw, oh, I think that was a miss. Yeah, it was a miss. The camera got a little too jerky to tell at first. Oh, is he going to melee the beacon? Yes. You crit the shit out of that fake person. You show them who's boss. That completely fictional person that does not exist. Oh, wow. Yeah, they both got focused on it. Nice. I can EMP the codex now. I should have a second one. Speaking of who... Oh, are you out? I thought I did have another EMP. Weird. Tombstone can't hit them with grenades. Has to, if I reload, I don't... Is it free? It's not free. That was my only shot. Hit chance is garbage, and it would make the codex split, so it's a bad idea. Where's my flashbang character? Do we have any more of those? I think it was the melee character, so we're all out of that. Rapid fire, 62% chance. 54. Neither of them are... They're not in Overwatch. It may suffice to run out in the open and go shoot that guy in the face.
Roger that.
Implacable means that if I pull it off, that I'll get on a movement turn afterwards anyway, so... Rapid fire, directly in the face, 2 shots. Don't let them split. There we go. So I should be able to move now, right? Because of her skill? Yep. Alright, so she'll be safe. I can get her to cover in a moment. Let's deal with the obvious threat. 66 is kind of garbage. Ah, take it. I mean, what else are we going to do? There we go. Proper damage. Now most things could finish him off. 2 damage. Who's the furthest back? You're my other sniper. At this point, we're just gonna move closer. This is everyone, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, that's everybody. Cypher has a full action still. Not sure what I want to do with you. I might just start sprinting for it, basically. Can I get up the ladder from you? Oh, yeah, I can.
Moving to designated coordinates.
I live up here now, next to the objective, where there's 17 berserkers. Oh, no. That'd be a horrible surprise. Just be like, oh, look, all the bad guys are up here. Fuck you. Let's take this cover. And then shoop. And then the shooting happens. Is he about to destroy his own cover? I'm never sure what to make of what the shooting's gonna do during my turn. I half expect him to destroy the only thing he's hiding behind. You can also get on the roof. We're almost at our objective to at least get out of here safe after completely failing. God damn it. Alright, Nightmare. You can make it all the way to cover. This is it. One more turn and everyone should be out, or maybe everyone except for the Grenadier will be there. Alright, this is it. Nope, Grenadier can make it. Who can't make it? Oh, the sniper and I might not be able to make it. They can't. They can only make it up here. Which I can't click on for some reason. There we go. Oh, right, the other sniper's gonna have a bit of a time getting up there, too. There's not even cover to take up here.
On the move.
Let's just get up there. And then everyone will be in range. Claymore. One action will get us up there.
Is this all sicher?
It seems like a bad idea to extract anybody early. So what I'm going to do is just have everybody in the entire party that can overwatch. And then if any surprises show up, everybody shoots it in the face, hopefully. Otherwise, we'll hopefully... Next turn, everybody will extract simultaneously. No surprises.
Your window for extraction is closing.
No surprises. Alright, extract.
Bereit zum Abmarsch.
C'est faisable.
What's over there? Affirmative. Moving out.
Just sending everyone over.
Moving out. Moving to position.
Extract. 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 Done. Oops, it's 5 for you. It's so far down the line compared to the others. There we go.
Ready to boogie.
The danger of using hotkeys in this game is that they change what the hotkeys do based on how many
Commander
tiles they put on the bar.
We'll need to review our tactics and improve going forward.
I mean, I didn't want to fail. God damn it. Oh, that I didn't even think about it. I didn't even think about the idea that the mech from across the entire map could fire a rocket to destroy the truck. The good news is I didn't lose anybody new. The bad news is 3 characters are wounded and I lost the character we were trying to rescue. Which is totally fucked. Better luck next time, I suppose. Ooh, the glowy chair. At least now when people are... Oh! Mostly they weren't too bad either. But yeah, at least now that when people are wounded, it's usually not for very long. I don't see lightly wounded very often. Does that mean he'll be wounded for even less time than the wounded character? Yeah, things really went to shit when that car exploded. Aside from the car explosion, the only wound would have been getting hit by the Lancer, which I kind of walked into, but I was specifically trying to distract them from having a situation where literally every enemy at once all shoots arose at the same time, who, funnily enough, escaped the fight with 0 damage taken. But the car explosion is not something I counted for at all, and... Yeah, that wounded 2 characters and killed 1. Seriously though, why didn't you guys bring a weapon for the guy you were saving? I just can't help but wonder that. Seems like a weird decision to not bring him a rifle. He's a sniper. He doesn't even need armor. He can help everybody out. But yeah, our only real loot is that, hey, 2 expanded magazines. That's nice.
Hello, Commander.
Otherwise we failed. Whoa, contact with the resistance in New India has been lost, and time to recontact has increased. Income decreased by 85 supplies. They actually I lost a whole region because of that, too. I didn't see that one coming. That's an extra problem. No, I like India. Well, that'll be a bit of a priority, won't it?